All right. Good morning, everyone. We continue with our marketing series with ADP. Quickly, I will be talking about the marketing dynamics. And here, we'll be looking at psychology of the market, the market size, demand and supply, market survey, creating a new market. Sorry to that. All right. Psychology of the market. Like I said earlier in our previous teaching, I said the market is marketing is an emotional thing, not a logical thing. It's an emotional thing. You employ your emotions in storytelling and things like that. Then, when we're talking about psychology of the market, you are looking at what you are selling exactly and the exact psychology that affects it. The exact psychology that affects what you are selling. For example, now, if you are selling wheels, you know, people love to trend with things, the happiness around, that is psychology around. They want to, like, for example, now, the new thing that is really now is this new shoe, Balenciaga, what do they call it? So that is the new thing people are buying now. That is psychology, that is the idea. Then you have to flow with what people are actually looking for. That is how to go with the psychology of the market. Now we talk about the market size. When you are coming in as a new marketer, the thing you should look at is how big is the market. That becomes a lot of things. How big? Say, for example, I want to sell to students in my area, let's say, Federal University of Technology and Career. I want to sell to them. I should be able to determine how big is this school. How many students do we have there? And how many of them, okay, we talk about that in market survey, but then in market size, how big is put up? That's how big is my market. And you remember, it's not everyone in that school that will buy from me, but that will give me a clue of what to do. For example, if the population is 20,000, I should be able to look out of 20,000, I should have a market of 1,000. That is how big my market is, and I will flow with that. Then we go to demand and supply. Demand and supply. You look at, okay, that market size will help you to determine this, your demand and your supply. What is the demand? And what should I supply? You know, there are people sometimes, many business owners, they just go there, buy things that nobody is asking for. And at the end of the day, they say they cannot sell. The reason being that you bought things without any demand. Nobody is asking for what you are buying. Then you start complaining that, oh, you cannot make it sales. Demand and supply. How many people are demanding for what you are supplying? Now, market survey. This is very, very important. Market survey. How do you do this? Let me tell you something. It is very bad to go into the market without a survey. Try to seek people's opinion. Try to know what people are saying. Try to understand what they are after and what they are actually looking for. You can do it by asking questions on WhatsApp. Do a Google form. Maybe ask on Facebook, on social media, or do one-on-one interaction with people, trying to understand what the market is looking for, where they are looking for the day, at what price, how do they want to look, and that will give you a clue on what to do. Now, creating a new market comes from the market survey. The market survey will help you to understand how to go about creating a new market. Market survey. We are the first people to understand how to create a new market. So your market dynamics, look at the psychology of the market, the size of the market, the demand and supply, the market supply, and then look for a way to create a new market. I think that is clear. Any other question, kindly send them to me. Thank you.